Thank you, Madam Chairman. The second request is also a conditional use permit. This is for a church facility in R-6 zoning. Property is located at the northwest corner of Woodlawn Drive and North Forest Street. Property has sort of a long, interesting history, which we'll talk about at our work session. But on the packet and on the screen, you see the zoning pattern. It is R-6 zoning all throughout, dominated by residential uses and institutional uses mainly in the form of churches. Character area established residential, reflects the zoning pattern pretty much throughout. And then area of imagery, older neighborhood, you see the rooftops of numerous houses. This is sort of a long, narrow parcel along Woodlawn that the rest of the world has grown up around, sort of left it behind. It's 2.4 acres. The survey and then the proposed site plan, you notice in the middle of this, there's one existing building there that is a tent manufacturing building. It really looks like an old concrete block warehouse, very plain. Obviously, it's been there a long time. It's also been empty for a long time. To the right, you see on the proposed site plan, the irregular footprint, that is an existing single-family residence at the corner of Forest Street. They're proposing to renovate that and perhaps use that as church office. The concrete building in the middle is to be renovated for church use, probably for gatherings and meetings. And then in between the two, where you're showing proposed parking, there's actually a single-wide little home that has been there a long time, I think has outlived its lifespan, and it is proposed to be removed. Again, this is a very conceptual site plan. There's a lot of extra land. But the applicant is related to the church across the street. They're proposing to acquire this and develop it. Subject property, here is the tent manufacturing building. Some would call that historic. I don't know how I would label that.
It's just old.
It's old. The mobile home that is in the center, and then the single-family residence on the east, which needs some TLC. As you see it from Forest Street, there's a lot of vegetation overgrowth, so it's sort of hard to see the property. But it is very much oriented toward Woodlawn. There is a traffic light at the corner. There's a crosswalk that the church is proposing to utilize. Pictures of surrounding areas, of course, the church sign for the main church facility. From interesting to the north is another church, New Life Bible Church. And then down Woodlawn, you have the single-family residential neighborhood, which is a typical pattern for that area. But back to the aerial image. This is entry from 2007, which is before the crosswalk, which you see on the far right of church parking lots and the proximity of the church facilities. And this is something they're wanting to expand. Staff's concern only really for institutional uses like this in the neighborhoods is the site plans, magnitude of use. What we like about this one is the main church facility is already established on the other side of Forest. This becomes more of an annex. With buildings that are there, that will somewhat limit the amount of activity, but I believe enough activity that is okay. And a crosswalk there with the traffic light coming across Forest. And I think it's a good reuse of the property that needs something. So with that, staff is recommending approval of the conditional use for five conditions that you see in the packet. The first one is approval should be granted for church usage of the property as a subordinate expansion of the Woodlawn Forest Church of Christ facility located across the street to the east, which shall remain the primary church campus. Uses on the subject property may include a typical single-family residence, church office, public school classrooms, playground, storage, meeting and social rooms, and church gathering space, along with any requisite restrooms and access and support rooms. Cumulative total of all existing and proposed buildings on this property shall not exceed 10,000 square feet of median gross floor area. That would allow for a modest expansion of either of those buildings. Together, I think they're about 7,000 square feet. Number two, the existing mobile home and then the existing outdoor storage material shall be removed from the site. single-family neighborhood to the north, so we have a non-residential type parking lot treated as such, within the landscaping as required for parking. Number four, the entire north property line should be maintained with a minimum 10-foot wide buffer yard and 6-foot tall paved fence, and a minimum 10-foot building setback distance. Number five, conditional use approval shall expire after 5 years from the date of approval if no building permit has been issued for any new building or existing building expansion or renovation. Now, my name's here. Glad to answer any questions that you might have.
Pat, I'm just curious, why are we limiting them on the square footage?
Part of it is the exact usage of the property is still a little bit unknown. As you see in the area, there's a lot of extra land that has the potential to hold a lot.
Right, that was my concern.
And the concern is a lot, depending on exactly what kind of use, might become something a little more intensive in terms of traffic generation or noise generation. So this doesn't carve it in stone, but allows them to use what's there, expand a little bit, and if they need to expand some more, they come back through the process, and then we have a more definitive answer of what's there.
Okay. Are they okay with that?
With specific numbers, I don't know. We'll probably find out.
Madam Chair, while you're on this, I'm just curious, man, is there a way to, and that's very restrictive. You got a lot of land there. Is there any way we can redo that verbiage to give us some option to maybe go back through you or whatever, but not do this whole process again? This is very restrictive to me.
Right. I mean, you can recommend whatever numbers if you like the concept of doing that. It's something we've done with other churches for conditional use.
Yeah, I agree with you. We have a lot of land.
Yeah. I mean, what if at some point in time they want to put a new sanctuary there, you know, and then use the old? I mean, I'm just thinking outside the box.
Right.
What if, without them having to come back through this process?
If they wanted to do that, I would consider that a major change. There was an intensive church use on the neighborhood side of the
place. Right, okay.
That definitely needs to go through the public hearing process.
Okay, gotcha.
But I'm just saying, if they wanted to go back and do a 5,000 square foot footprint of a jail, under this verbiage, they couldn't do that unless they tore the house down.
Right, and then it's under 10,000. It depends on what number you want to keep. But think of potential impacts of, you've got a 5,000 square foot building there now. You add another 5,000 on top of the other building that's there, so the 10,000 square foot gym plus the house, family life center.
If you have a 5,000 square foot existing structure, a 2,300 existing structure.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, if we could soften the verbiage, allow them to put another 5,000 square foot facility there, that'd only be at 12,200. But yet they could have a, I don't know.
Maybe just change, I mean, whoever makes the motion to whatever, you know, just know that you have the flexibility to change that additional
script. And one more question, for your photo just a second ago of the craftsman style household property, you showed a shot of Farm Street.
Right.
See, you could go one more, if you can. I'm just curious, why?
Talking about the adjacent house?
No, I'm talking about that, the craftsman style house that they're going to buy. I'm just curious.
One that's on the property.
Yeah.
That's it.
I'm just wondering why we, because I don't see those sidewalks on Farm Street. Curious, why are we impacting them with that?
Because right now you have a crosswalk from the church that doesn't connect to anything.
Mm-hmm. Right. Those sidewalks.
Yeah, we need sidewalks.
So, I mean, because the crosswalk's there, I get that now. I see what you're saying now.
And it's not showing in the aerial, you might see.
Is it? You got pictures?
See, neither side of the forest, and then we don't have one at the intersection. We have generally north sides of streets. So a new construction, there's going to be requirement of a sidewalk anyway along Woodlawn.
But that's
maybe where that sidewalk would lead to going west down to Valdosta Park. And then there needs to be some connection with pedestrian movement on forest, which definitely needs more sidewalks. Right now we have a traffic light and a crosswalk there. The crosswalk's floating in space.
Right there, Woodlawn.
And crosswalk.
This aerial is a little bit too old, but as you look up in that, like to the north along Forest Street, you see sidewalks that, you know, eventually we need to connect to. This gets this property one more piece of that puzzle in between, and all that remains is the next parcel to the north. And once you have that, then you've got a continued sidewalk on the west side of Forest.
Is that their responsibility, or would that be the city's?
They, as owner of the property, they're redeveloping a corner lot. They are responsible for sidewalks to put in per the city engineer, whatever they require. And it's highlighted by the fact that there's a crosswalk going to nowhere.
I see the cross. This over here. I see it now.
It shows up on the view there.
Yeah, it shows it right here, too.
Got the letter that's in there, the site plan itself, which labels what is to become of the two buildings that remain. I mean, it's fairly general term on meeting space, in the house or church office. And that's a small
so that
5,000 has the potential to be more. I mean, if there's a church daycare center to go in, that's a whole new ball game. And in fact,
we'll move forward then. Commissioners, do you have any other questions before we open it up?
So there is some sidewalking on Woodlawn, what I'm understanding. So you're asking them to just extend it from that point down to Clark.
They're going to need to anyway with building, but because it becomes a condition of approval for these
steps. Zero, you can see the sidewalks from the existing house. I saw just a second ago, Matt, when you had it up.
You can see it is right, but
on the aerial, you can see it. See it right here?
Yes,
yes, you can see it right there. Now,
I want to run it from there down the cross.
No, you want to see it from here to the cross. Thank you, sir.
If you look off the left edge of this area, it's all of the park and property.
That's right.
And remember the city is on the trail.
Yeah.
And the park.
All right. So we'll open it up to anyone wishing to speak on behalf of this request tonight. Please come forward and state your name and address.
Good evening. I'm LeRoy Butler, and I'm the minister of the church there at Woodlawn. And the thing that brought this about is that we had previous plans of expanding on our main campus, 17,000 square foot addition, and when the pandemic hit and prices went through the roof, we were unable to continue with our plans. And so the 2.5 acres across the street became a kind of a fallback, a plan B, if you will. 7,000 existing square feet within to build. And so that's our interest in those buildings. We could bring them up to renovate them and use them for space. And that's basically what we need. Space to house ministries, additional space utilized for classroom activities. The building on the corner, the house, would possibly be used for additional offices. There's staff and there's staff that don't have offices, and so that would be the most probably the practical use for that at this stage. And regardless of the sidewalk, if I'm not mistaken, I believe those sidewalks on Woodlawn come all the way to Forest Street to that crosswalk now. So I'm not sure what we're discussing. If we're discussing sidewalks on Forest Street going north, the sidewalks in at East Moore Street. In other words, on the northwest corner of North Forest Street is where the sidewalks end. There's a residence across that intersection, and there's no sidewalk in front of that house. And there's no sidewalk along the east perimeter or boundary of this particular plat. There's a ditch there, but there, of course, there's no sidewalk there. So is that what we're
discussing? That's what we're discussing. So the eastern boundary of the property
right
is what will require the sidewalk. Am I not right, Mayor?
That's right.
No, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. On the west side of the road. But
oh, yes, sorry. Yeah. West side of the road, but the eastern side of the property. Yes.
Is that part?
Right there.
Right.
That's the east boundary of the property.
Correct.
On the west side of North Court. So we're discussing a sidewalk from Woodlawn to where?
To the end of the property.
Oh, to the end of the property. Oh, okay.
I'm sure you probably saw something to get you off, but there is on their drawing showing that as Matt said, well, there's a crosswalk across the street. He wants to make sure it goes to a solid surface rather than a grassy.
Right, it ties into that.
Right, there's a corner feature there, and I think that's all that's right there in the corner.
That's
the sidewalk that's been extended.
The crosswalk goes over to the sidewalk
along Woodlawn.
Yeah, crosswalk. If you cross that street, you're going to step onto a sidewalk on Woodlawn.
But your sidewalk goes down Woodlawn. It doesn't go.
Correct.
Matt is asking for is that section on Forest
right. That
does not have sidewalk. So we're talking about from here to here.
I'm sure if you see that sidewalk that you just put your pin in, just deadhead right there. I'm going down and see it deadhead.
Right.
It doesn't connect to the crosswalk.
Correct. So, Matt, you're asking for sidewalk from here to here and to tie into here. Is that correct?
Correct. And okay. Up the frontage on Forest.
Right.
And eventually we'll connect to the next lot.
And your plans are to move the mobile home?
The answer, short answer is yes.
Okay. Okay. Well, I just wanted to make sure that was something that you already had planned and that was not a surprise to you.
Well,
okay.
We won't be moving. It's not a part of the sale.
Right.
Right. So the current owner will move that.
All right. Commissioner Brain, did you have a question earlier?
No,
did we get it? Okay.
Mr. Butler, I'm just curious. I'm sure you heard us discussing with Matt about his cumulative total for the footage. What's your thoughts on that, sir?
Well, it sounds a little restrictive. In an R-6, normally we permitted residential in R-6. And currently at the end of that parcel, or duplexes. And so in terms of what we would do with the additional space, we had not really formulated a plan for that. But the reason we're acquiring these is because of an expanding industry and being able to house what we are currently doing in a good facility and effective way. So the honest with you, I don't have a hard and fast or, you know, opinion about it. The more latitude we could give them, the better, which is better, I think. But in the absence of having, you know, a solid plan for what we're going to do,
Any other questions for Mr. Butler? All right.
Madam Chair, I do have a question. Thank you, Mr. Butler. I have a question for staff.
Okay. Are,
is the concrete building or the existing house, are they considered historic right now?
No. By age, yes.
By
characteristics, I would say probably not.
This is not a historic district or historic area?
It is not. Not the local district.
So my question is, if they could tear down either the concrete building or the existing house if they wanted to under, okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, okay. So if they were to tear down both that those buildings, they would still have a maximum of 10,000 square feet for the property?
Correct.
Okay. Okay. Did we use our time?
No, we still have some
time. If there's anyone else here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request, we have a moment. All right, if not, is there anyone here wishing to speak against this request? You'll come forward. If you will state your name and address, please, sir.
My name is Hubert Ward Jr. And I got a misunderstanding about the whole thing, which I thought they was going to try to put a church right there with a concrete building at.
Mm-hmm.
And I was against that.
Okay.
But since they're not, I ain't got nothing to say.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Mr. Ward.
Okay.
All right, is there anyone else here tonight wishing to speak against this request? All right, if not, we'll turn it back over to the commissioners for any final discussion.
Sure. I've seen Jimmy Holmes up out there. Jimmy, you read that one. So you made his red rings?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There's a the old stucco manufacturing facility. You going to just reskin it from the outside? Is that what the plan is? Or leave it as is?
The masonry building?
Yes, sir. Is it going to be reskinned or just let
it? Yeah, we actually submitted.
I see something here, Jimmy. It looks like.
Yeah, it's in the packet.
It looks like stuff on something. I'm just curious. We'll make sure.
Yeah. Matt had asked us to come up with something for the front of the building.
Yes, sir.
And what we propose is some residential looking windows, mm-hmm. and reskinning the front of the building, turning the corner a little bit with it. Mm-hmm.
Just want to make sure that's what I was looking at.
That's perfect.
Thank you.
All right. If there is no other discussion, then I will open it up for a motion.
Madam Chairman.
Yes, Commissioner.
Paul. I would like to make a recommendation. Follow staff recommendation. Find it consistent with the comprehensive plan of conditional use review criteria. I recommend approval to the City Council. Subject to the following conditions.
Okay.
Madam Chairman.
I'll second.
All right.
We have a motion to approve and a second. Do we have any discussion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. All those against, and the motion carries.